Khashoggi was in fact murdered and dismembered. And I believe in the order of the Crown Prince. And I would make it very clear, we were not going to, in fact, sell more weapons to them. We were going to, in fact, make them pay the price and make them, in fact, the pariah that they are. There's very little social redeeming value of the in the present government in Saudi Arabia.
Well, allow me to retort.
Hey, soldiers, that was Joey B, Joey Bananas, basically back during the campaign, telling the Saudis how their crown prince, Mohammed bin Salman, we could give him a piece of his mind, talk to him about human rights and all that jazz. United States talking about human rights is a joke, okay? And if you want proof of that, take a look at the situation on Rikers Island. You get arrested in New York City, and before you are convicted or even tried by a jury of your peers, you're sentenced to a hell in Rikers Island. Look it up, okay? And once you look at that situation on Rikers Island, you know, then you'll begin to understand that the United States does not have some divine authority to, you know, preach to others about human rights. All right. Drive down into Baltimore City, across from the post office at the foot of 83. And depending on what time of the year it is, you'll see tent cities set up. Okay. With a lot of homeless children in these camps. Okay. And now here's the thing. Homeless people are everywhere in the world. I get it. But every now and then, when something, you know, flashy is coming to the city, I remember when we had the Grand Prix come through, they went in and cleared those folks out. You care where you go, you just can't stay here. Let's get off of this human rights thing, okay? We're not the ultimate authorities on that, all right? Again, I love the country, but this government is so duplicitous and so... it's so hypocritical, okay? So they're preaching to Mohammed bin Salman, and of course, I don't like what they did with that reporter, Khashoggi. But I do have some questions about that. Khashoggi, come on, you were a smart man. Why'd you go in there? You knew those guys were capable of exactly what they did to you. But, hey, it's too late now. So that's what he had to say. Okay, now, in the most nonsensical, baffling turn of events, Biden has selected to go to Saudi Arabia and beg them to increase output, oil output. Okay, now, if I'm a Saudi prince, if I'm a prominent member of OPEC and I see the United States bending over backwards to create a situation whereby this green revolution will totally take out oil, okay, but they want me to increase output so that prices can come down and they can drive, they can use that to drive further away from the use of oil. I'm not increasing anything. You know why? Because I want your citizens to feel the pain. Because when they do, they will make a change in the regime. And look, I am all for alternative sources of energy. I believe that the ones that make the absolute most sense are geothermal and nuclear. Now, here's why I believe that. Well, I'll tell you why I believe that in a minute. But if I am Mohammed bin Salman, I'm going to say no. I'm not going to increase output because I want to drive you and all of the greenies out of office. You guys want to make this transition a snap. And you want to make it a light switch. And that's not going to go over well when you're telling people who can't afford $5 per gallon gas to buy a $64,000 electric vehicle. So the more economic pain that Americans feel, the quicker they will be so inclined to get your ass out of office and get someone in there, that someone like me, who is okay with renewable energy sources, but is mature enough, adult enough, economically savvy enough to understand that this needs to be a progression, not a light switch, all right? So, why I like geothermal and nuclear? First of all, nuclear suffers from the stigma that it is also a weapon, okay? And it is a weapon that has been used, that has been threatened to be used. So it's got that going for it. Then we've got Fukushima, Three Mile Island, Chernobyl. The branding on this stuff is horrible. But in recent years, the science has gotten better. So nuclear is a clean source of energy, okay? Europe probably should have, you know, expanded. France said they're expanding on nuclear in order to diversify their energy sources. The rest of the European Union is kind of cooled on it. But it's a clean source of energy. It is a source of energy that is relatively inexpensive. Then you also have geothermal. Geothermal is basically where they just stick a rod down in the ground, take heat from the earth, and use that heat to power things. All right. We should develop that technology because the energy inside of the earth is pretty much perpetual. It's going to be there for many eons to come. It is a limitless source of energy for our needs, okay? We need to explore these options. We need to really... Geothermal is already in place. It's working. But you don't hear it talked about as much. Now, when it comes to solar and wind and these EVs, you do the research. Go take a look at the disposal of solar panels and wind turbines and batteries for EVs, okay? You want to talk about an environmental crisis, that's one that we need to have some answers on right now. Most Americans, most people in the world, I would imagine, don't question where the power comes from when they plug something in to an outlet. And you can come under the mistaken impression that because you've got solar power, that there's never any environmental hazard in that chain of events, and nothing could be further from the truth. Have you ever thought about the life cycle of a solar panel? What happens to it after it's no longer in use? How long does it take to break down? How is it disposed of? In an area, the area where I live, there are people who put solar panels up, and those solar panels now are not as glossy as they were. They are, you could tell some of them are not in commission anymore, and they're hanging around like eyesores. And I'm like, okay, what happens to this now? So if you're really truly concerned about the environment, we need to get all of the information. And we're visual creatures if we don't see it out of sight, out of mind. Biden's going over there now, and he's going to beg Mohammed bin Salman and the Saudis for this oil. Now, you heard him. Okay, he was very adamant. Now he's being asked, well, look, if you're going over there to meet with them, are you going to meet personally with the man that you had so much to say about in the debates? Biden's saying no, he's not going to do that. He said, I'm not going to meet with Mohammed bin Salman. I'm going to an international meeting, and he's just going to be there at the meeting. Well, guess what? The Saudis say, that ain't so. The official Saudi press release is very precise, even outlining specifically what's on the agenda in the Biden and bin Salman meeting. The first day of the visit will include a meeting between the custodian of the two holy mosque, King Salman bin Abdulaziz Al Saud and President Biden. Okay, so that's the king. The Saudis said in the release. Next, they said President Biden will meet with His Royal Highness Crown Prince Mohammed bin Salman bin Abdulaziz. That's a quote. The Crown Prince and President Biden will hold official talks that will focus on various areas of bilateral cooperation and joint efforts to address regional and global challenges, exploring cooperation on emerging technologies, economic investment, space, renewable energy, cybersecurity, climate and environmental initiatives, food and energy security, and expanding trade and commercial ties to enable both countries to confront mutual challenges and seize opportunities for the 21st century. So they're going to talk about Biden's going over there. Please release some more. And they're going to say, they're going to use all this cover, all this gobbledygook to eventually say, nah, not going to do that. Let your people continue to suffer. Let your gas prices continue to rise. And then Biden's in a fix because he can't go back now and release the sanctions on Russia. You can't do that. You look like a complete idiot, okay? So he's got to have that stay on the table. So you cut off that supply. OPEC, in my estimation, is not going to, up the ante in terms of production. And, inflation's still going to hang around. Interest rates are going up. James Carville, he was one of the advisors for President Clinton when he was running for office of president against George H. W. Bush, the father of George W. Bush. And Carville came up with this saying that is so accurate and still applicable to this day. He said, "It's the economy, stupid." And that's exactly what it is today. It was the economy, stupid, back then. When Clinton ran for office, the economy, stupid, right now, especially right now. Think about what I just said. Inflation. Let's take that low number that they always talk about. 8.9%. You've got food shortages. Gas prices through the roof. Diesel prices through the roof. Tampon shortages, ladies. Okay? So much for the female vote, right? I guess they weren't too, concerned about the baby food shortage. Even though that did concern moms. And dads too, I suppose. But tampon shortage. So we've got all these shortages, higher prices. It's going to cost you more to carry over that balance on your credit card. Okay, it's going to cost you more to buy a house because interest rates are going up. And this chump is out there talking about he's going to run for re-election. Yeah, right. What can you do? Well, I've told you many times before, you need to pick up the phone. It's an election year. And you need to tell your congressman and your senators. You have two senators, one congressman or woman, whatever. You need to tell them that we need to start drilling right here. Why the hell are we running down to Saudi Arabia, over to Saudi Arabia and down to Venezuela, begging them to do what we have the capability to do? If it's an environmental issue, what are you saying exactly? Okay? What are you saying? Are you saying it's okay to destroy the environment of colored people in Venezuela? Are you saying it's okay to negatively affect the environment of colored people in the Arab world? Is that what you're saying? If that's not what you're saying, then why can't we drill here? Because we're on the same damn planet. It doesn't matter where you get the oil from. It's the atmosphere. It's one atmosphere. It's not like America has its own separate atmosphere from Saudi Arabia. Okay? So, either these people are insane, insanely stupid, which I doubt, well, they have an agenda. Now, there can't be both. I've heard people say both. Talking to a friend the other day, and he was saying that Jerome Powell was stupid, and Jerome Powell, the chairman of the Federal Reserve Bank, is clearly not a stupid man. Come on, y'all. Jerome Powell is a man, to me it seems, who is acting with an agenda. All right. And that agenda includes obscuring the truth from you if you are inclined to believe everything he says, right? But, for example, inflation is transitory. Well, let's talk about that. Jerome Powell said inflation is transitory. If you spent an hour in a college-level macroeconomics class, you would have known from the start that was not correct. It was a lie. I didn't spend an hour in a macroeconomics class, college level. If you watched at least 3 Soldiers of Finance videos, you knew that we told you that there was no way you could keep printing money, putting it out there, and not have inflation. We were saying this way back in 2020 when they were first talking about sending stimulus out, okay? And then we really got on that topic when Jerome Powell was saying, don't worry about it. We can do this and there will be no inflation. And when Janet Yellen was saying the same thing. So yeah, they can say whatever they want to, but don't abdicate your good sense when you know whatever it is they're saying is not correct. Now, everything they say is not incorrect. Everything they say is not a lie. You look at this situation with the CBDCs or the central bank digital currencies. They want to put that into effect the better to control you with. It is a push. Look at China right now and the way that they control their citizenry economically and otherwise through the social credit system. China had a big run on banks a few weeks ago. The citizens wanted to get together and protest. China hit all of them with the social credit scarlet letter, basically, that disallowed many of them from traveling or getting lodging. All right. This is what they want to bring to America. They wish to God they had that in Canada when those truckers had that whole thing, because you saw how Canada reacted. Or we'll just seize your bank account. You made a donation to wrong think. So we're going to seize your bank account. What do you do in this type of environment? How do you navigate through this? Well, look, for the viewers of this channel, and please share this video, just hit the thumbs up. It's not gonna, it's gonna take you like a millisecond of your time. And then subscribe if you're not subscribed. For the viewers of this channel, you need to buy land that you can either rent to people, but you need some land where you can grow some food on, okay? You need some land where maybe you have some timber you can sell, okay? You need to set up an ecosystem, an economic ecosystem, whereby you can continue to exist. You can continue to eat, clothe your family, and live under a roof when it starts raining, even if the government decides that you are guilty of wrongthink, so therefore they have to interdict your finances. You saw it happen in Canada. You see it happen in China. You saw it happen in America. And now you're like, no, I never saw it happen in America. Yes, you did. They said, do a certain thing, take a certain medication, or you're going to lose your job. Okay? No questions asked. You want to work? You want to work? Go ahead and do this. Well, what if I do this? Would that mean you won't ever lay me off? Hell no, it doesn't mean that. We might lay you off next week. But if you want to work with us, until that time, you go out there and you do this, okay? So you've seen governments get a taste of blood. They want to control people, individuals, through economics. Corporations are very willing to have this happen. That is why I am a big advocate for you having multiple streams of income. You've got to do that, okay, in this world today. So pick up your phone, call your congressman, call your senator. It's an election year. They are terrified that they might not be allowed back in the Capitol after January of next year. Okay? They're going to lose their job. You have the power to have people lose their job. Call them and tell them, look, you need to suspend the gas tax right now so that Americans can keep more money in their pocket. But you need to create a bill that allows us to drill here, okay, now, and get some oil out of the ground to contribute to the global supply, and bring these prices down so that the retiree, the family with 2.5 kids, the small business owner can continue to thrive in this country, all right? Not just the elites, not just these jokers on cable news. And, you know, they're going to tell you how it is. They're making millions of dollars, okay? This is what you need to do. Do that. Call your representatives. Call your state representatives. Tell them to put a moratorium, a temporary moratorium of a year on your state gas tax. Tell them to get in bed with you and suffer and cut your budgets like we've had to, right? And start looking at some land. And you might say, well, everybody's not going to be able to buy land. Well, everybody doesn't watch this channel. Okay, so a lot of people throughout the world do. And we have a lot of people throughout the world who subscribe. But for the people who watch this, for the viewers that I get, oh yeah, each and every last one of us can go out and buy some land that we can produce some fruits and vegetables on, and maybe even enough land to raise some cattle and chickens. And guess what? It's not going to be a problem, okay? Don't complain about Bill Gates buying up all the farmland. There are at least 3 acres out there for you. All right, guys, I'll talk to you soon.